chicken crumpet snack for you. Now that all the straight men are gone, I need your help. Please.
How y'all doing?
I am sorry. I'm already making an apology video. That, unfortunately, was the only way I could get my target audience for this video. What you ask? The girls and the gays!
Period!
Why I need your help? Well, hold on. I'm about to tell you. I need to be friends with Brittany Broski, like, need.
No.
It's like that need and validation you want from that toxic boy named Josh, yeah. Which you are currently thinking of right now. Stop. He is not going to message you. Don't check your notifications, love. We both know that he doesn't want to talk to you. So, this is my virtual friend application. But first, I'm going to give you some history. Like all of you, we saw this beautiful woman on TikTok. I did see Brittany before the kombucha video, but that's the one that caught my attention and made me follow her. And seeing her skits along my For You page, it just made me appreciate the creativity that woman has brewing in her head. Like, it's so amazing. Honestly, I couldn't think of that. Like, this video is scripted, and it's not even funny. She could improv. Your whole life is improv. It's truly amazing what she can come up with. And at that moment, I was like, damn, I really want to be friends with Brittany Broski. No cap. So, I decided to call her out on TikTok, which only got 7 likes, so I deleted it. Let's just say she did not see it. 7 likes for a call out to be friends with a famous TikToker. Yeah, no. Like, I'll remake the video right now. If you're not Brittany Broski, keep scrolling. We'll just wait a bit, Brittany. Hi, Brittany Broski. I'm calling you out because I'd like to be your friend. Yes, that's it. No spice to the video or anything. I'd like to be your friend. Oh, and we could do accents together. How fun. How super duper fun. Only thing got going for me is accents. How fun. As you can tell, that didn't show my personality one bit. And no wonder it got 7 likes, because I was like every other basic bitch on here going, period, poo, be my friend, dude. Finger pony. Ew! Finger pointing. Fuck. So a few months roll around after making that, I wouldn't even call it a video. Anyway, on TikTok, and I'm deep diving on the YouTube, just typing the weirdest shit I could think possible. And in the corner of my recommendations, I see a video from ex-Viner now TikTok star, Sahara Shower, Brittany's cousin, sister, wife, roomie. I can't keep count anymore. They keep adding on more. Wouldn't surprise me if they're lovers at this point. So I see her video on YouTube, and I see Brittany in the thumbnail. So I'm like, hell yeah, click that shit. I clicked that shit so fast. Like, this duo is so funny. I haven't laughed in so long on YouTube, right? It's so boring here. And I would just watch YouTube videos for the hell of it, because I'm just bored. I'll be sitting there like the ceramic doll your nan has in her house. It's like, it's so cute, but just like stares you to death when you're sleeping in her spare bedroom, like. That's how I was watching YouTube for the last couple of months until these guys came along. Like, they're so hilarious. So after just binging all Sarah's videos with Brittany, I see that Brittany's got a YouTube channel, and let me just say, did not disappoint. Period. I was watching her video about, like, changing up the vibe in her room, and in that moment, I thought of this video, because, like, I'm just straight calling her out. I need to be Brittany's friend. Like, I need to be Brittany's friend. As I'm hunching over the kitchen cabinet, scripting for this video, while watching the psychological impacts that food has on Nikado Avocado, I give you, without further ado, I think that's right, here is my virtual friendship application for Brittany Broski. Enjoy. Hey Brittany, if you're watching, hey doll, you should come over more. Ugh. People, let me tell you about my best friend. Picture this, right? We've just had the most amazing sleepover and we walk downstairs and your dad has just made us a fresh bowl of cereal for breakfast. As he puts my bowl down, he has a bit of a stank to him and I can't lean over to you and be like, yo, Brittany, your dad stinks. We create a secret language that no one else knows. So instead of me going, Brittany, your dad stinks, I'll be like, hey, Brittany, your pa, dad pa, smells pa like a woman pa. So hilarious! And he wouldn't even know about it. We would be laughing our heads off and he'd be like, whoa, what's so funny, girls? What's so funny, girls? We're gonna be like, your pa, dad pa, so oblivious pa. Oh yeah. This language will be so handy. We'll be like shopping for our sleepover, right? And as we're checking out the man, checking out our food, you go, in our language, hey Cassidy, go get the pubic tweezers. And I'd be like, sure. And he was like, whoa, that was like super sexy. Where are you from? And you'll be like, Europe. I'm from Europe. I'm just realizing that just sounds like a porno. Well, struth, welcome to Down Under. Rip of a country, eh? As I'm Australian and that then and there would just win the argument of you being my friend, you Americans cream about coming over to Australia. Imagine coming down here and having free accommodation, like not having to worry about paying for a hotel for like however long you're here. You can crash at my place and in return I can take some long lost vibes that I've been missing out on my whole life. Just don't ask me where to go. Yeah, I get it. I've been living here my whole life, but me and my friends still struggle where to go. And that's why we never go out, because we don't even know the place. Like, tourists know the place better than us. So, because of that, I actually never get out of the house. Can't find one? Do you wish you had someone to laugh with? Well, say no more. I am standing right in front of you. I am sick of laughing at my own jokes because I know I am annoying and not funny. Trust me, I have no idea why people think I'm funny. It swings in between me talking about my dad leaving me and me just screeching out of nowhere. Nothing in between. I mean, I know I won't beat Sarah, but I could be that long lost triplet you were just wondering what happened to because your parents told you that you ate me in the womb. But in fact, it's because I just wouldn't shut the f*** up and they gave me to someone else. I have no idea about you, Brittany, but for me, I have different laughs for different situations. I can't show you what those laughs are because they only come out during them, but I am very much aware I have different kinds of laughs. But Brittany, your laugh, it's so funny. Like, I have a really fucking weird laugh. Our laughs put together would just be, we'll be laughing at something funny you said, because trust me, I am not funny whatsoever. And my laugh would come out and then you would laugh at my laugh and then I would laugh at you laughing at my laugh. Trust me, out of anyone's laugh in the world, I would love to pee my pants just a little bit. Love. And just full send it and soak my pants. That's like someone's fetish. I swear. Yuck, no, I don't mean it. Oh my god. Us eating food together? That's it. That's it. For me, it's an endless food battle because I want to kill a bod. But then on the other hand, if I'm full as fuck and I see this banging cheesecake and I'm like, well, it's here and I won't be able to have it when I go home, so I might as well. So I don't honestly give a fuck anymore. Food is so good. Food is so good just to not eat it. You name the meal and I'll cook it for you. I love cooking food. Like, I love baking goods, cooking food and giving it to my family and seeing their reactions to see if they like it or not. Like, it's just amazing just to see just the accomplishment that someone likes something you've made. So no matter how hard it is, I'll try my best to give you that meal. If you weren't my friend and you're just like, all right, bitch, cook me a meal, then leave my fucking house right now and never speak to me again. I'd be like, yeah, let's go to America. Like, I would love to cook for you, man. Also, snack swaps. As I said before, the only thing I have going for me is that I'm Australian. The snack swaps we could have. Bitch, I know, since the platter that you and Sarah made, y'all have a fucking good taste in snacks. I think you had bullets. I don't know if you call them bullets, but like the licorice with the chocolate over the top. And you had pickles. Oh! Orgasmic. Pickles are orgasmic. Can't change my mind on that, but you guys have like the best taste in snacks. Your variety, endless. I can give you some snacks from Australia and we can just do snack swaps every now and then. Like, you could be like, yo, Cass, I won't give you anything in return, but can you like get me some more Tim Tams maybe? I'm like, yes. Anything for you? Snack swaps. Just imagine it. The vibes. The vibes. TikTok dancers. I know you like to get your ass up at 2 a.m. and do a TikTok dance because you're like, damn, that shit's fire as fuck. That is me too. I'll be spending 2 hours learning to dance. Do the dance. Save it to my drafts because that shit was bad. But I am a very fast learner and I can help you learn a TikTok dance. Or even, we can make our own TikTok dance. This is what I wrote down. I am fun to be around and I can be there for when you're down. Which is what automatically what a friendship is. And these bitches out here don't know. I'm gonna get deep for a second because I'm just gonna talk to my audience. if they haven't gave you the respect that you have given them, that's not a friendship. What I said before, that automatically comes. You shouldn't have to earn that at all. Like, damn, some bitches out here going, I'm sorry for what I did. If they were your friend, they shouldn't have to be sorry. The amount of times that they should ever have to be sorry. Like, if it was something petty, if they, like, hit you in the face or, like, by accident, you can be like, oh, I'm sorry. But if they, like, went behind your back and did all this shit, they shouldn't have to be sorry if you wanted them to be your friend. If you thought they were friends. So don't take those toxic people back in. Same with a relationship. If he's cheated on you, and you know who I'm talking about, if she's watching my video, if he's cheated on you and he's so sorry and so remorseful for it, he wouldn't have to be sorry. He shouldn't have done it in the first place. Period. Don't go back to his ass. I'm calling you out online. Don't go back to his ass. So, Brittany, what do you say? Will you be my friend or nay? Will you take my hand in friendship? Let me know, please.